Welcome everyone. In this presentation, we will try to cover the Ebers small model representation of a BJT. So, before that, we will start with some fundamental concept related to this Ebers small model. Before that, we have to know the basic thing about the BJT. So, I am drawing the NPN transistor first. So we are very familiar with this transistor. So this end is nothing but simply a collector, base and emitter side, and this one we can say the NPN. So now what I am doing in this Ebers small model is basically an electronic representation. We can say this one is an electronic representation of a BJT that includes both forward and reverse forward active mode operation in a single schematic. That I will tell you later what it signifies in detail. So this one is nothing but simply a model. Okay, so for forward active mode, so for example forward active mode. So in case of forward active mode, the base emitter junction, that is our base emitter junction, is in the forward biased, and the base collector junction is in the reverse biased. And similarly for the reverse active mode, I am not writing. In reverse active mode, this will be interchanged. Base emitter junction reverse bias and base collector junction will be forward bias. So what happens, this representation of a transistor can be also viewed as some current source and so this one is somehow say the T model, we can say collector in, base in and emitter in. Now what I am doing, this current is your IC. I am writing for the instantaneous current, both DC and AC component will be there. So this one is the representation of the instantaneous one. I in the small letter, small, and the subscript should be in the capital letter. Okay, for the DC one, this I should be capital and C should be also capital, both in capital, for capital, and this one is also capital. This one is the representation for this one. Is your instantaneous, okay, and this one for the DC representation, and for AC both will be in the small letter, both is in the small letter. So this will be your AC signal. Okay, so this one is already covered in my one of my video lectures. So this one is some representation that we have to think for the instantaneous one in which both the symbol will be small one and the subscript should be capital. In case of DC, both will be capital, and for the SE one both symbol as well as subscript will be in the small letter. So I am using the instantaneous one, so I am writing this as IC current, and this one is more or less IB, instantaneous base current, and some current is flowing, that is our IE, and this voltage is our base emitter voltage, okay, and this current, this IC, is nearly alpha times IE, or we can say this one, by using that formula we can say this IC equals to alpha times of I of E. So this current is nothing but simply we can say alpha F I. Now I E instead of, now we are saying this is a somehow some diode, okay, so this one is because NPN, so we are treating this one as a diode, so we can write this one as IDE, or this IE is nothing but simply your IDE. So this current is also we can say IDE. So this one is the circuit representation when the diode is in the forward active mode. Okay. This one is the representation when the diode is in the forward active mode. Okay. This one is the representation when diode is in the forward active mode. Okay. So here the base emitter junction is forward bias and base collector junction is reverse bias, that I am not showing. The another way of representation for the reverse active mode, this one for the forward active mode, for the reverse active mode, okay, for the reverse active mode what we are doing, we are making very similar type of thing, but the current direction will be more or less different. So this should be our collector, base and emitter in, and we can say this will be your simply your I B, and this one capacitor diode will be DC, and this one due to reverse active mode this would be alpha R I times of DC. So this current we can say this one is simply IDC. Okay, so this one is the another representation, and if we club these two okay together, that will give the Ebers mole model. Okay, it is very simple, means just we are making for the forward active mode and reverse active mode, and we have to sum together, or we have to make it a single system, and after that we have to find the current. Basically in this Ebers model we have to find out the terminal current expression, or we can say in this one you have to find the terminal current expression. Okay, means we can find simply our IC, IE and IB, that we have to find in this lecture. So this one is one of the representation. So what actually we are doing, so after that what we are for the forward active mode we have to make the, so I am making the a complete picture. So this one is your base, this one is your collector, and this one is our base, and this one is our emitter. Okay, and for the time being, here what we are writing, this one is your DC, and this is our DE, some diodes representation. Okay, and this one, this current that is simply alpha F I DC. Okay, I have to check. And this one, due to reverse active mode, this one should be I DC. Okay, this should be DE, because this section is due to the forward active mode. And the another one, the red one, this red one is the reverse active mode. Okay, so what we are doing, so now it's a little bit confusing, so again I am drawing the same diagram. So this one, if you practice one or more times, it will be very easy. So this one is your collector in, base in, and emitter in, and this one is the one current direction. So basically we are making the T model for the forward active mode and reverse active mode, and this one is nothing but simply say for forward alpha F, common base current gain, into this one is more or less IDE, the current in the this one. So we can write this as a IDE, this current is our IDE, and this one is reverse active mode, it should be alpha IDC, and this current in this diode will be IDC, and this current, the instantaneous collector current, should be IC, and here this will be your IB, and this one will be your IE. If you are able to write this current equation, DC across the diode, DC, the current is IDC, IDE, alpha F, IDE. Okay, so after that, what we have to do, we have to write the only the Kirchhoff's current law one by one, and we have to solve the this model. Okay, so first just think about the point A. So for that point A, I am making a separate diagram, I am writing this point say A. Now for A, there the current are IB, and one current is going here, that is our IDC, and another current is going in that direction, that is your IDE, and the another current is coming from this one, your alpha F IDE, and the another current is coming in that direction, say alpha R IDC. So now we can write the current equation. Okay, so for this current equation in that particular point, so we know the KCL, current, incoming current equals to outgoing current. So we can simply write the expression IB plus this incoming current, say alpha R IDC plus alpha F I DE equals to outgoing current, two outgoing currents are there, IDC plus IDE. Now finally what we can write, IB if IDC is there, if by taking common IDC, it should be our 1 minus alpha r plus IDE, and our IDE is 1 minus alpha f. So this one is the first equation that we can easily find in terms of alpha r and this one, the expression for the instantaneous base current as a function of IDC and IE. Okay, so is it clear? Now similarly, we can find the current expression for the other one. Okay, so what we have to do, what we are doing now, say this point is our B. So again we have to apply simple Kirchhoff's current law at the B point. So for the B point, very simple. Okay, I am not very expert in this my pen tablet, so I'm getting some time. So this one at point, this one should be our IC, and the another current will be our say IDC, and another one is going out like alpha F I D E. Okay, so now the total incoming current at that point should be our IC plus IDC equals to alpha F ID, total incoming current equals to total outgoing. So we can write the IC, the collector current, terminal current IC, as a function of alpha F IDE minus IDC. So this one is the other expression. Okay, for the terminal characteristics IC, it is very simple Ebers model, in which we have to just make a model when the device is, the NPN device is working in the both active and reverse active mode, and club it together and find out the expression for the different current, different terminal currents like IC, IB and IE, that I will show you step by step. So this one is the IC value for the collector current, terminal current as a function of alpha F, the common common base current gain, common base reverse current gain. So now this one, now we have to think about this point C. So now at point C, say this current is our IE, okay, and this one is our alpha R, IDC is going out, and one current is coming like IDE, okay. So now in that case, what we have to write, total incoming current equals to total outgoing. So we can write IDE equals to IE plus alpha R IDC. Okay, IDE coming, this point is our C, so this is IE plus. So similarly we can write the expression, I am here writing IE equals to IDE minus alpha R IDC. Okay, so this one is the other expression for the IE. Okay, so now we have already find the expression for the IB value, IB value, okay, IE and IC. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to just use the diode equation and we have to put the IDC value and IDE value one by one, and we have to find the value of the terminal currents. Okay, so for this purpose, what we have to do, first I am writing the diode equation. Okay, so basically the diode equation very simple, IDC equals to some saturation current, say ISC, then EXP BC by VT minus 1 equation, and IDE for the emitter 1, it should be our ISE EXP VPE by VT minus 1. Is it okay? Very simple equation is there. Okay. These two are very simple, means we are writing the diode equation. Okay. For the ID and IDC and ISC. Okay. So now we have to put the value of IDC one by one in the equation, say, I am writing the name of that equation, say equation 1 or say equation 2 or equation 3. Okay, so what we have to do next, this already we have find the the value of other term. Okay, so I am starting with the very simple expression, say IE. Okay, here it is written IE equals to IDE. Okay, so you can write this one, I am starting with the equation, say I. So now instead of IDE, what we have to write, the saturation current, say ISC, then in bracket EXP VBE by VT minus 1 minus alpha R, and IDC value is ISC EXP VBC by VT minus 1. I am not doing complex mathematics, I am just putting the these values. Okay, so after that, by putting this value, and I am using this equation, say equation number 3, after that what we have to do, I am also writing one for simplification purpose, alpha F into I S E the saturation current, and alpha R I S C is nearly equal to some constant saturation current, say I C. I am using this concept. Okay, means the saturation current in both active and forward active and reverse active mode will be almost same, and alpha F the forward, we can say the common base current gain and common base reverse current gain into the saturation current will be somehow equal, that is equal to I S. So after that, okay, I am taking some different color, select green one. Okay, so for IE we are writing the expression, so IE equals to ISE. Okay, so now instead of ISE, what we can write, we simply write IS by alpha F. Okay, and the other one will be the constant. Okay, very similar to the same expression. Okay, so I am writing again VBE by VT minus वन माइनस अल्फा आर इज ऑलरेडी देयर ओके एंड आई एस सी कैन बी सिंपली रिटन एज आई एस इंटू अल्फा आर. सो दिस अल्फा आर कैंसिल एंड दिस वन ई एक्स पी बी बी सी बाई बी टी माइनस वन ओके. सो नाउ आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस वन आफ्टर सॉल्विंग दिस एक्सप्रेशन वट वी कैन राइट ओके मीन्स दिस ओके स्टेप बाय स्टेप आई एम राइटिंग सो इट टेक्स टाइम बट ओके. सो इट शुड बी 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 ई बाई वी टी माइनस वन माइनस आई एस ई एक्स पी बी बी सी बाई वी टी माइनस वन. नाउ फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड कंडीशन फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड कंडीशन फॉर फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड ऑपरेशन व्हाट वी हैव टू डू दिस वी बी सी वैल्यू विल बी निगेटिव ओके मीन्स रिवर्स बायस ओके. सो दिस इज रिवर्स बायस सो दिस विल चेंज टू जीरो ओके ई टू द पावर माइनस एक्स ओके. सो दिस वन इज नथिंग बट सिंपली माइनस एक्स टर्म सो ई टू द पावर एक्स इज लाइक दैट ई टू द पावर माइनस एक्स. सो फॉर द निगेटिव इट विल गोज टू जीरो सो दिस वैल्यू विल बी जीरो. सो आफ्टर दैट बाई पुटिंग फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड वी आर जस्ट सिंप्लीफाइंग दिस एक्सप्रेशन. सो द फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन आई ई कैन बी रिटन एज आई एस बाई अल्फा एफ ई एक्स पी बी बी ई बाई वी टी माइनस आई एस बाई अल्फा एंड दिस वन शुड बी प्लस आई एस. सो बाई टेकिंग कॉमन आई एस ओके फ्रॉम हियर आई एस सो आई एस टेकिंग कॉमन वन देन प्लस ओके वन माइनस वन माइनस अल्फा एफ इज इट ओके. बेसिकली व्हाट वी हैड इट दिस वन नाउ दिस माइनस आई एस एंड दिस माइनस प्लस सो एंड हेयर वी कैन राइट आई एस बाई टेकिंग कॉमन माइनस वन बाई अल्फा. सो दिस वन इज द वी कैन से द फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द आईएस टर्म इन टर्म्स ऑफ अल्फा एफ ओके एंड दिस वन व्हेन फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड फॉर द फॉरवर्ड एक्टिव मोड द एमिटर करेंट विल बी दिस वन ओके. नाउ सिमिलरली फॉर द नेक्स्ट वन मीन्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट वन सो से टेक द एनी वन ओके अगेन टेक द सिंपलेस्ट वन आई सी द इक्वेशन नंबर टू. सो हेयर आई एम राइटिंग द आई सी इक्वल्स टू अल्फा एफ आई डी ई माइनस आई डी सी ओके. सो वॉट वी कैन राइट दिस आई सी अल्फा एफ एंड आई डी ई. सो आई डी ई इज द डिफरेंसिबली द डायरेक्ट करंट सो आई एस ई ई एक्स पी बी बी ई by Vt minus 1 okay minus IDC. So I am writing here IDC. So we can write ISC into here I am writing EXP VBC by Vt minus 1 okay. So now this ISC can be written as IS by alpha F. So this one simplifying अल्फा एफ इंटू कॉन्स्टेंट आई एस एफ ई एक्स पी बी बी ई बाई बी टी माइनस वन माइनस आई एस सी. आई एस सी कैन बी रिटन एज सिंपली आर आई एस बाई अल्फा आर. सो आई एस बाई अल्फा आर ओके. So now for the forward active region, we are telling that VVC is negative, so it should be 0. So minus IS pi alpha, it should be minus minus plus. We can write simple by simplifying. We are putting 0 for the forward active mode. Okay. So this expression is now again, this should be cancelled. So finally what we can write, IC equals to, then here we can write IS EXP VPE by VT, taking say IS common, we can write 1 by alpha R minus 1. Okay, so this one for the other one means IC value 1 by alpha R minus 1. So this one is the expression for the IC one. Okay, in this expression again I am writing here, we are taking the VBC 0 for the forward active mode, for the forward active mode. Okay, e to the power VBC, because VBC is the negative one, so e to the power minus x should be going right there, so it should be 0. Now we have to go for the base one. So for the base one, again we have to start with the very simple expression IB. So this IB value will be IDC, okay, 1 minus alpha R plus IDE 1 minus alpha F. Okay, so here what we are doing, IB value, again write IDC nothing but simply your ISC EXP VBC by VT minus 1 into 1 minus alpha R plus ISC, then EXP VBE by VT minus 1. Okay, so it will be minus 1, and put in bracket, it will be better. Okay, and 1 minus alpha F. So okay, so after that what we have to do, okay, I am writing one step by step. Now this ISC, now this ISC can be written as some IS by alpha R, okay, because there is expression na, I alpha F I S E equals to alpha R I S C equals to say some IC. We are repeatedly using this concept. For more detail you can go for the microtonics book, Sedra and Smith. So I am using the concept from that book, and I am trying to solve this one step by step. So you can also go to the book for more detail, but I am doing a full verification of this one. So IS by alpha R, and this one EXP VBC by VT minus 1 minus alpha R. Now here we can write IS, okay, so there is IDE na, so here it should be ISE, sorry for the mistake, ISE, so it should be alpha F I, okay, and it should be 1 minus alpha F, here I am, and again EXP VPE by VT minus 1, okay. So this one is the expression. Now suppose we have to solve this one. So one more thing is there. 1 minus, here I am writing. 1 minus alpha f by say alpha f. So what should be the value? So what should be the value in terms of beta if anyone had to write? Okay, so first we know, we have to know alpha equals to beta by beta plus 1. Very simple, some fundamental formula that we have to know. 1 minus alpha. So what is this one? If we reverse this one, 1 by beta, 1 minus alpha by alpha. Okay, so this one is nothing but simply 1 by, you can say beta f. Yes or no? This one is nothing but 1 by beta f. So what we are writing, this IB AJ IS by say beta, here we can write 1 minus alpha r by r equal to beta r and exp vbc by vt minus 1, okay, plus is by beta f, okay, beta f, we can write this one, and this would be our exp vbe by vt minus 1. Now again what we are saying, that VBC, this whole term will be 0 because we are talking about the forward active mode region for this, for to evaluate the value of IB value, okay, the instantaneous one. So it should be IS by beta R minus IS by beta R. So okay, again I am writing IS by beta R term will be there, plus IS by beta F exp vbe by vt minus IS by beta F. So again I am writing the same thing, IS by beta F, just simplifying the this expression vbe by vt. This is a very important concept and it is very simple. Okay, so it should be written as beta r plus 1 by beta f. This one is beta. So this one is nothing but simply the value of IB. This one is the final one for the IB expression, we can say. So in that manner we have derived the value of IC, IB and all these terminal in terms of the their terminal characteristic. So once again I want to repeat the reverse mode model. So in this model what we have to exactly do, first we have to think about this forward active mode operation, okay, that is our this one forward active mode operation, okay, or we can say that you have to use the T model, okay. So we have used the T model, okay, not working, okay, I have to select something, T model, okay, for NPN transistor, for NPN transistor we are doing, so we have made this one. And for the reverse active mode, slightly it will be different, that is in the up and the current will be like that, because this one is the reverse active mode, say this one is your NPN transistor. For the reverse active mode, the base emitter junction will be reverse bias, so reverse bias, so it should be plus minus, and it should be the base collector junction is the forward bias, forward bias, okay, so it should be like that. So the current direction will be somehow initially for the NPN it is like that, but so now this one is the direction will be NPN base emitter, say this one's first right, sorry, this one is your emitter, base and collector. So base emitter junction forward, sorry, base emitter junction will be reverse bias, so sorry, it should be, okay, I have to use some eraser. This one for the forward active, okay, so make it for the forward active mode first, okay, for the forward active mode base emitter junction is forward bias, Okay, and for the reverse, see, for the reverse pair, it should be reverse active, reverse one. Okay, so the emitter current will be like that. Okay, and the base one and the collector one is more or less going to. Is it okay? Okay, once again I am doing the same one with the very simple. First, do it for the active forward active mode. I am here making for the forward active mode. NPN. Okay, base emitter junction. This one say emitter common base. Okay, so emitter, this one is N, and we have to go for the forward active. So base emitter junction forward bias, so it should be N plus. Okay, and this should be the reverse bias base collector, so this should be N is connected to the negative one, positive one and negative one. Okay, so this one is the simple base emitter junction forward bias and the base collector junction reverse bias, and this one for the reverse active mode. So the current direction will be different. Okay, so we have made these two diagrams, and after that making the all circuit arrangement, we can say this one is the symbol direct final, we can say the final circuit diagram for the base emitter junction in the forward active mode and base collector junction in the reverse active mode for the forward active mode one, and the reverse active mode we have to take the just opposite to the first one. So this one is the diagram, and the corresponding diode we have to make it for the diode model. So we are putting the DC for the collector diode and DE for the emitter diode, and by using the step-by-step simple KCL and KVL, we can derive the value of IC, ID and IE value. So this one is the simple way to derive the expression. Thank you for watching, and also please subscribe my channel. So you can also go to the book, what we can say, the Microelectronics Seddon Smith book for more details. So, okay, thank you for watching. Thank you.